work by friction. Friction is a contact force which act along surface. Friction are of two types, kinetic and static. Kinetic friction is one in which contact surfaces slide on each other. Static friction is one in which contact surfaces does not slide. Kinetic and static friction can do negative, positive or zero work. Let us illustrate this using few examples. Here we have a diagram in which the man is pushing the block and as a result the block moves forward. So when the block moves on the ground, say which is rough, the ground exerts kinetic friction on the block in backward direction because the contacts slide, and as a reaction the block exerts kinetic friction on the ground in forward direction. Since the kinetic friction on the block is in backward direction and the block is moving forward, therefore work done by this kinetic friction is negative on the block. As a result, the block will lose its energy. A part of its kinetic energy will get lost. The reaction kinetic friction, which acts on ground, acts in forward direction, but the ground does not move. That is, its displacement is zero. So the work done by the friction on the ground is zero. That is, this friction does not provide any energy to the ground. But here is one inconsistency, that by the virtue of negative work, the kinetic friction has extracted work, that is energy, from the block, but it had supplied no energy to the ground. Where does this energy go? Whenever we have a mismatch in work, the amount of work done which is mismatched goes into heat or is lost in other forms of energy. Because energy was extracted by negative work from one body, but it was not supplied to the other body. For the man, the foot of the man, say, is firm against the ground while pushing the block. So the friction on the foot of the man will be static, acting in forward direction, and work done by this friction on the foot of the man will be zero as there is no displacement. So here no energy exchange takes place. Let us take another example. A block is placed on the bigger block, which together moves with the bigger block. So at the contact surface between the two, friction force acts on the upper block in forward direction because it is the friction which will move it forward. This friction will be static because there is no sliding at the contact between the blocks. As a reaction, the upper block will also exert a friction which is static on the lower block in backward direction. Now, with respect to an observer on the ground, the observer sees the upper block moving forward, that is, having displacement in forward direction. So, positive work is done on the upper block, whereas the same observer sees the lower block also moving in forward direction. Therefore, work will be negative by this static friction. So, note here that static friction can do positive as well as negative work. Since the force and displacement pairs are same, the only difference being that they act in opposite direction, so the amount of energy extracted from the bigger block by the negative work is completely transferred to the upper block. That is, here the friction extracts energy from one block and supplies it to the other block. So this is how work done by kinetic or static friction can be negative, positive or zero. Thank you.